But actually, he has made his desires, his lusts, God. Why? He is obeying them without seeing whether it is halal or haram. It is permissible or prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A desire emerges from your id or libido, from amongst your animal instincts, and you follow the desire, you fulfill it. All gratification of that desire you do without seeing whether the way you have adopted is permissible according to the Sharia of Allah or prohibited. So now who is your Lord? Your God is your nafs. Now nobody has ever bowed towards his nafs or prostrated before the nafs, but this is the practical shirk. I might think, and I might be proud, I'm 100% muwahid. Because as far as the tawheed in creed is concerned, tawheed fil aqeedah, well, I am satisfied that I have fully understood it and I take it. But what about this practical side? Taisa abdu dinare wa abdu dirham. Woe to the servant of dinar and dirham, bondsman of dirham or dinar. His name is Abdul Rahman. Actually, he is Abdul Dinar. When he is after getting dinar, without seeing whether it is halal for him or haram. The love of dinar, the love of dirham, the love of money and wealth is more in their hearts than the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who is their Lord? Who is their God? Practically, wealth. They are worshipping wealth, worshipping dollars, worshipping pounds, worshipping rupees, and takas, etc., etc. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَٰهَهُ هَوَاهُ وَأَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has led him astray. Despite all his knowledge, he is a PhD. PhD in tafsir. He got a PhD from McGill in hadith, in fiqh. But he is the bondsman of his wishes. You might be an alim. You might be a mufassir. You might be a muhaddis. You might be a faqih. You might be a mufti. But if you are serving your lusts and desires, irrespective of whether something is permissible or prohibited, then you are mushrik in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَخَتَمَ عَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَجَعَلَ عَلَىٰ بَصْرِهِ غِشَاوَةً. And of such a person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put a seal on his heart and on his hearing, and there is a curtain before his eyes. فَمَنْ يَهْدِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ اللَّهِ. Now who can give him the guidance after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has, so to say, put a seal on his heart? أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. So are they not admonished or reminded? وَقَالُوا مَا هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا. And they say, there is no other life for us except this life or this world. مَا هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ. We die ourselves. وَنَحْيَا. And live ourselves. Now, يُحْيِي and يُمِيت means Allah gives life. Allah puts you to death. They said, no. We die ourselves. We live ourselves. This is the materialism of this age. There's nobody. This is the world of matter. There are laws of physical change, laws of chemical change. Under these laws, this universe is going. There's no need of some controller and somebody running this universe. No. We don't believe. وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرُ. And nothing kills us except the time. Time passes and we are finished, that's all. No God. This is dahriyat. You might have heard this word, dahriyat. Materialism, dahriyat. وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ وَمَا لَهُمْ بِذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عِلْمٍ. They don't have any knowledge of it. إِنُمْ لَا يَذُنُّونَ. They are only conjecturing, guessing. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ. And whenever clear revelations are recited unto them, مَا كَانَ حُجَّتُهُمْ. Their last argument is, إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا اُقْتُوا بِآبَائِنَا إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. In the long run, in the end, they always used to say, okay, if there is going to be resurrection, bring our forefathers before us. Then we shall believe that there can be resurrection. قُلِ اللَّهُ يُحْيِيكُمْ. Say, Allah will revive you. ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ. Allah is keeping you alive, يُحْيِيكُمْ. ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ. Then He will put you to death. ثُمَّ يَجْمَعُكُمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. Then He will gather you all together to the day of resurrection, in which there is no doubt. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people know not. وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And for Allah is the sovereignty and kingdom of the heavens and the earth. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ. And the day on which the hour will come. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَخْسَرُ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. On that day, the followers of falsehood will be the losers. وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاسِيَةً. كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاسِيَةً. And you will see all the nations. They will be kneeling down. كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ تُدْعَى إِلَىٰ كِتَابِهَا. Every ummah, every group, every nation will be called towards the book of the record of its events and deeds. And then, الْيَوْمَ تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And then it will be said, today you will be rewarded and recompensed for what you had been doing. هَذَا كِتَابُنَا. This record of ours, this book of ours, يَنْتَقُ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْحَقُ. It is speaking against you with truth. There is nothing wrong in this record. As I said, it might be a computer, a big joint computer. Simply, you press a button and the life of a person, of an individual, the whole film might start. Now, how can you deny? You are doing it. See it. Is it not you? How will you deny? هَذَا كِتَابُنَا يَنْتَقُ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْحَقُ. إِنَّا كُنَّا نَسْتَنْسِخُ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. We had been writing and recording what you were doing. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Now so, those who came to believe,